question. Classify into monomials, binomials, and trinomials. You know what is monomial, binomial, and trinomial. So monomial means expression which contains only one term. Okay, which expression contains only one term is called monomial. An expression which contains only two terms are called binomial. An expression which contains three terms are called trinomial. Okay. So next, if an expression contains more than three, that is multinomial. Okay, or we can say the polynomial. So now the given expressions, first you have to classify. So first column in that you can write monomial, and the second column you can write binomial and trinomial, or you can write that, or direct you can write this is which expression, monomial, binomial, or trinomial. I think this is easy. First you have to make columns, like first one monomial, binomial, trinomial. So in that you can write your expressions. Okay, now if you observe first one, 4y minus 7z, 4y minus 7z, this expression is, which contains two terms, isn't it? The given expression 4y minus 7z, in that there are two terms, one is 4y, another one is minus 7z. So there are two terms. Two terms means that is what? Binomial. So 4y minus 7z is a binomial. And see, second one, second expression is y square, just only one term, y square, means that is monomial, single term monomial. So next, third one, x plus y minus xy, so it having three terms, so write this is a trinomial. So x plus y minus xy is a, for example, to trinomial. Then fourth one, 100. 100 means there is no any variable, so only number is given, 100. So that comes in monomial form because that is single term, single. Okay. Next, fifth one, AB minus A minus B. AB minus A minus B, that there are three terms, AB minus A minus B. So now, sixth question, 5 minus 3t. 5 minus 3t is a binomial. 5 minus 3t. And next, seventh one, 4p square q minus 4pq square. So here also, this is also a binomial. Two terms. P square q minus 4pq square. This is very simple. Classify, just you have to observe the given expression. If expression is having two terms, then that is a binomial. Three terms of trinomial. Single term, one term, that is a monomial. Mono means a single. Okay, bi means two, tri three. So like that. Okay, now next expression, fifth one, AB minus AB is over. Next term, seventh one, 4p square q and minus 4pq square, this is binomial. And the 8th one, 7mn, means that is a single term, monomial. And 9th one, z square minus 3z, so this is a trinomial. Z square minus 3z plus 8. Next, 9th one, or 10th one, a square plus b square is a binomial. A square plus b square, that is binomial. And z square plus z, this is also a binomial. Z square plus z. And last expression is 1 plus x plus x square, this is a trinomial, three terms. Is there any other expressions? No. So given expressions, you have to classify as monomial, binomial, and a trinomial. Yes, thank you. In the next question, see, you have to identify the like terms and unlike terms. See, state whether a given pair of terms is a like or a unlike terms. So like terms and unlike terms. See, like terms means any two factors are given. This is what algebraic expressions, right? So in this algebraic expression, if you get the same variable x, x. So this is what same variable x, x. So if you get any same variable terms, then that exponent also must be same. Means here what is the exponent of x? The power of x is 1, and here exponent is 1, x power 1, okay, degree or exponent or power. Okay, x power 1, x power 1, same in this, and variable also same, means x, x, same variable with same exponent. So that is what a like term. Okay, algebraic factors must have a same factors, same variable and same exponent. That is what like terms. Unlike terms means must have different variables. Maybe x comma x one term and another term is having y. So these are different variables. So that is what unlike terms. And if the variable is having same, the terms is having same variable. If the terms is having same variable, maybe x 2x and if this is 4x. So this is like terms. And same variable with different exponent. Exponent is here 2 and exponent is here 3. So is it they are like terms? They are not like terms, because variable is same but exponent is a different. Exponents are not same. So like terms means both your exponent and variable must be same. Okay. So in this, for example, 4y squared and 3y. 4y square comma 3y, here 4y square and y, so they same variable y, but the exponent is here 2 and exponent is here 1, so they are not like terms, they are unlike terms. Okay, same variable but exponent is different, so that is also unlike a term. For example, if they given 3y and 4x. Okay, 3y square and 4x square. In these terms, see, variables are not same but exponents are same. Is it they are like? They are unlike terms, because they are having different variable with same exponent. Okay, this is the unlike terms. Same variable and same exponent. X square, 2x square, comma 4x square. So these two are the terms. One is 2x square, 4x square. They are like terms because they are having same variable with same exponent. Clear? So variable may be any. For example, 4z and 7z, minus 7z. They are like terms because having same variable. Exponent is 1, exponent is a 1. So sometimes we get like this, 1 by 2z cube and minus 3 by 4z cube. So this is like terms, same power exponent and here also same variable. That is like terms. Okay, now you have to identify the given expression. You identify like terms and unlike terms. Okay, you will see what are the like terms in this given expression. If you want, you can make two columns like this. First column write like terms, and second column you can write unlike terms. Like terms and unlike terms. So in this, like terms means, see, 1, 100. First one, 1, 100. This is comes under like terms because they are a constant. Both also constant. Both also number, isn't it? So 1, 100 is a like terms. Next second one, 7x minus 7x comma 5 by 2x. So if you observe this, this is one term and this is another term. Both is having same variable, x, x. Even exponent also same. See, x power 1, x power 1, they are like terms. Minus 7x, comma 5 by 2x. So this is the like terms. Next, third one, minus 29x, minus 29y. Is it they are like or unlike? They are unlike terms, isn't it? Because the variable is here x and in this variable is y. So different variable, different variable. So that is unlike term. Minus 29x comma minus 29y. So third, fourth one, plus 14xy comma 42yx. So if you observe this, the variables are here x, y, x into y. And in the next term, the variable is x, y only. Means only x. Order is different, right? X, y, y, x. 2 into 3 also we can write, or 3 into 2 also we can write. Isn't it? What is the answer? 6. also 6, 3 2s also 6. So we can write in any order like xy or yx, but it having same variable xy, x1. Is it correct? Yes. So they are like terms, but the exponent also same, isn't it? X, y, same exponent, same variable. So that is what like term. So 14yx, comma, is given xy. Okay, right? 14xy, comma, 42yx. 42yx, they are like terms. So next, fifth one, 4m square p, 4m square p, comma, 4m p square. So the variable is same, m, p and m, p, same variable. Next you have observed, the exponents are same or not. So here m exponent is 2 and here m exponent is 1. Is it same? No, they are not same. And variable is p, the exponent is here 1 and p variable exponent is 2. So these two are not same. Same variable but exponents are different. So that means they are unlike terms. Okay. 4m square p, comma, 4m square p, comma, 4m p square, 4m p square. So they are unlike terms. Next term, last expression, 12xz, comma, 12x square z square. So this is also unlike term because same variable with different exponent, with a different exponent. So this is a unlike terms. Understood? How to identify like terms and unlike terms? Very important. So first you have to see whether variables and exponents are same or different. So if it is same, then that is a like terms. Different means unlike terms. Okay. The next question, an algebraic expression, same. Simplify by combining like terms. Simplify by combining like terms. In that first one, 21b minus 32 plus 7b minus 20b. So here, first you have to combine a like terms and then you have to simplify. So direct we cannot solve this, isn't it? So can you subtract 21b minus 32? So here we cannot simplify. Then what we have to do? First you have to write the like terms together. So which is the like terms here? 21b, 7b and 20b. These numbers, these terms are like terms. Why? These three terms are like terms. 21b, 7b and 20b. Because they are having same variable. The variable is here b, b and here also b. Even exponent also 1, 1 and 1. So that means same exponent with same variable. So that is like terms. So first you have to combine like terms. Means you have to write together. Like terms write together. So 21b plus 7b minus 20b. Okay. Minus 20b plus, sorry, minus 32. So only like terms write together. 21b, 7b and 20b, these are like terms, same variable, same exponent. So then 32 is a constant, so write separately, minus 32 in the last. Okay, now you have to simplify. After combining like terms, next you have to simplify the terms. So now 21b plus 7b, the answer is a 28b. Why? Because they are having same sign, plus plus, same sign, addition. 21 plus 7 is 28. So plus 28b and next remaining term, that is 20b, 20b, 28b and 20b, they are also like terms, so we can simplify. Plus 28 minus 20, 28 minus 20, so here different sign is, you know, subtraction. So we have to subtract 20 from 28. So 28 minus 20, that is 8b. Later number is plus. Later number is 28. That sign is a plus. So now plus 8b. If I simplify these two, I got plus 8b and remaining terms 32 write as it is. Now again, can you subtract 8b minus 32? So this is not possible because they are not like terms. They are unlike terms because it having variable b and here there is no any variable. So this is constant. So constant and variable we cannot simplify. So 8b minus 32 is the final answer. Okay. The next question, second one. See, your second one is minus z square plus 13z square minus 5z plus 7z cube minus 15z. Here, if you observe the same variable, the variables are same but exponents are different. That means they are unlike terms. So, can you make a group like combining like terms? So, now you have to combine like terms in this given algebraic expression. So, now if you observe this algebraic expression here, z square, they are like terms, isn't it? Because having same variable and exponent also same. So we can write minus 7z square plus 13z square. So these two are like terms. And similarly, we can write 5z and minus 15z together. These two are like terms. Minus z square and plus 13z square and minus 5z minus 15z plus 7z cube. Cube, is there any terms? No. So write z cube as it is. Now if you observe z square, they are like terms. Same variable, exponent also same. Here same variable, exponent also same. So now we can simplify these two, isn't it? Minus 1z square plus 13z means different sign, minus 1, z square means 1z square, okay? Minus 1 plus 13, different sign means subtraction. So 13 minus 1, that is 12. Greater number is 13, that sign is a plus. So 12z square plus 12z square. And similarly, we can simplify these two, means minus 5z and minus 15z. Minus 5z and minus 15z, same sign, minus minus. That means addition, 15 plus 5 is 20z. 20z, so greater number is 15, that sign is a minus. So minus 20z. And remaining one term, that is 7z cube. 7z cube, so that is what? Unlike terms, because there is no any other z cube term. So that you will write as it is. The next step, the terms we got 12z square minus 20z plus 7z cube. They are unlike terms. So we cannot simplify these three terms. Okay, this is the final answer. Thank you. Okay, the next question. See, simplify by combining like terms. So now here you have to combine like terms, then you have to simplify. So but here to combine, the terms are given like this, p minus into p minus into p minus q. Some terms are given inside the bracket, right? So first you have to remove the bracket. So how to remove this bracket? First term, that is p, right, as it is, and here it is given minus. And what is the sign of p? The sign of p is a plus. So plus into minus, you have to multiply these two. To remove this bracket, you have to multiply the sign, minus into plus, that is minus. Minus into plus, minus p. Okay? Bracket means multiplication. So here you have to multiply the sign. The sign is not given. What is the sign of p? The sign of p is a plus. Okay? You can consider sign is plus. If sign is not given, then that means the sign is a plus. So plus into minus, minus. And again multiply the sign by second term, minus into minus, minus into minus, plus. Now next term is a q, minus into minus plus q, and next q right hand is a, now again, so to remove this bracket, sign is here plus, multiply the sign, minus into plus, minus q, minus into minus, plus p. Okay, now you can simplify directly. Because there are some terms are like terms and some are unlike terms. So first you have to combine the like terms. Like terms are p minus p plus p minus p, and one more term that is plus p. They are like terms because same variable, even exponent also same. Next term plus q minus q minus q. So these are another like terms. So in this, plus p and minus p get cancelled. These two terms are get cancelled, and plus q and minus q get cancelled. So what is remaining? Remaining p minus q. So these are the terms of a given algebraic expression. Clear? So first step, it is first you have to remove the bracket. Otherwise, we cannot combine like terms. First, remove this bracket. How to remove this bracket? First, we have to multiply the sign. Okay, minus into plus, minus, minus into minus, plus. Okay, remaining terms write as it is. Again, minus into plus, minus, minus into minus, plus. In the next step, combine like terms together, write together, and simplify. Plus p minus p, that is zero. Okay, 1p, 1p, different sign, subtraction, 1p minus 1p, that is a 0. That means, see, these two terms get a cancel. Here also, plus q minus q cancel. So what is remaining? Plus p and minus q is a remaining. So now, the next question, that is fourth one, says 3a minus 2b minus ab, 3a minus 2b minus ab, and minus into a minus b plus ab plus 3ab plus b minus a. So here some terms are given inside the bracket. So first you have to remove the bracket. So now write 3a minus 2b minus ab. Okay, next minus into plus, now multiply the sign, minus into plus minus a, similarly minus into minus plus b, again minus into plus minus a. Okay, understood? Minus into plus minus, minus into minus plus, minus into plus minus. So next term, the last term, plus 3ab plus b minus a. So now we have to write like terms together, means combining like terms. Here 3a, a is a variable, and is there any other same variable? A, same variable means a. So write a together. So 3a is one term, and here we can see minus a, and one more a term is a minus a. So minus a and 3a are like terms. Okay, next term is minus 2b, and is there any b terms? Yes, that is one is minus 2b and plus b. Next term, and one more b, that is 1b plus b. Okay, minus plus b plus b, is it correct? Yes. Next term, another variable, that is ab, minus ab, minus ab, and another ab, that is also minus ab, and plus 3ab, plus 3ab. So they are what? Like terms, right? Like terms together. A, and b, and ab, and ab. They are like terms. So first you have to combine like terms, then you have to simplify. Clear? So 3a plus 3a minus a. Now we can simplify this. The sign plus 3a and minus 1a. Okay? So here sign is different. Means plus minus. You know plus minus means a different sign, subtraction. If you get same sign, addition, different sign, subtraction. So 3 minus 1, that is a 2. 2a. 3a minus 1a, that is 2a. Here, the greater number is 3, that sign is a plus. So, plus 2a, and remaining is what? Another a, right, as it is, minus a. Okay, next, again, 2b minus 2b plus b, minus 2b plus b means different sign, plus minus different sign. So, now we have to subtract, from 2 you have to subtract 1, b means 1b, okay, 2 minus 1, 1. and sign is a variable is b, and which is greater number is 2, that sign is a minus. So minus 1b and next one more remaining b write as it is. Okay, now in the next step now we can say minus ab and minus ab means minus 1ab, here coefficient of ab is 1 and here also coefficient of ab is a 1. So that means c sign is minus minus means same sign, you know, same sign means a addition. So 1a plus 1a total 2ab. Okay, 1ab plus 1ab total 2ab, in this which is greater, ab and ab which is greater, so both also same, so the sign is a minus, minus 2ab. Remaining terms plus 3ab, right, as it is plus 3ab. Now again we can simplify this because they are like terms, because same variable a and exponent also same, so that means they are like terms. So we can now simplify plus 2a plus 2a minus 1a plus 2a minus 1a, they are having different sign, plus minus, so different sign means subtraction, 2 minus 1, here coefficient of a is 1, so from 2 you have subtract 1, 2 minus 1 is a 1, so variable a, the greater number sign is a plus, so plus 1a. Again minus 1b and plus 1b, minus 1b and plus 1b, these two get a cancel, that means that value is a 0. Okay, the answer is a 0. Understood? Minus plus means different sign, from 1b you have to subtract 1b, 1b minus 1b, that is a 0, or you can write like this, direct you can cancel 1b, 1b, if different sign is there, minus plus, so these two will get a cancel. Next, minus 2ab plus 3ab, minus 2ab plus 3ab, they are also having different variables, sorry, same variable, ab, ab, same variable, and sign is different, different sign, same variable. From 3 you have to subtract 2, so from 3 if you subtract 2, remaining 1ab, okay, greater number sign plus, so plus 1ab, therefore the answer is a plus ab, a plus ab, or you can write 1a plus 1ab. Understood? First you have to remove the bracket, just multiply the sign, plus into minus minus, minus into minus plus, minus into plus minus. So next step you have to combine like terms, right, like terms together, and in the next step you have to simplify the like terms. Finally the answer we got a plus a. So while writing the sign you have to check which is the greater number sign was writing the given terms. Okay.